Now, beyond just counting the number of sig figs in a measurement, you also need to be able to do math with your measurements. And there's rules for reporting the answers to mathematical manipulations for these measurements. So for adding and subtracting, you limit the significant digits to the digit in the first column or the largest place value in one of the measurements. So in this case, we have 11.2 grams plus 12.14 grams plus 13 grams. So if I line them up, it's a little bit easier to see the columns. 11.2 and what I'm talking about there, 12.14 and 13. In this case, this measurement here, the 13, does not have any digits in the tenths or the one hundredths place. So this ones place is going to limit the accuracy of my answer. And so when I add these numbers up, I end up with 36.34 grams. I'm going to have to limit my answer to the ones place, so I'm going to have to report this measurement as 36 grams. Okay, now what if I would have added my numbers and I would have had, instead of 11.2 here, 11.4? I would have changed my answer by 0.2, and so in that case, if these were my numbers and I added them up, the answer would have been 36.54 grams. In this case, I still need to report to the ones place, but because the next digit after the one is 5 or greater, I need to round up. You follow your normal rounding rules. 5 and above, you round up, and below 5, you round down. So that would be 37 grams, would be my answer, had this been 11.4 instead of 11.2. Now, for multiplying and dividing, the rules are a little bit different. You limit the significant digits in your answer to the lowest number of digits in one of the factors. So in this case, I've measured a mass and a volume. So I'm calculating a density here, which would be 24 divided by 127. And when I do the math, I end up with this number from my calculator, 0.188976378 grams per milliliter. That's read straight off my calculator. But according to the rules, I'm going to limit to the fewest number of sigs in one of the figs in one of the factors. And in this case, 24 is 2 sig figs, and 127 is 3 sig figs. So I'm going to have to limit it to 2 sig figs. And since the digit following the 2 sig figs is greater than 5, I'm going to have to round up. So to correctly report this measurement, this value, this density, it's going to be 0.19 grams per milliliter.